We are deeply in a water crisis. We have up to 3 billion people lacking water every day for their livelihoods. But we're also undervaluing water, because water is not only about Sustainable Development Goals 6 for drinking water and domestic water, it's also the water behind food, behind energy, behind all livelihood, behind carbon sequestration for climate security. So behind all the Sustainable Development Goals, behind everything that we talk about as human development, there's fresh water. So we need to place that centrally in the economics of water. And the third really big breakthrough with this report work is that we now unfortunately must recognize that we're changing the very source of fresh water, precipitation. We are changing the whole hydrological cycle, the functioning of fresh water on planet Earth, which means that water is now and must be recognized as a global common good, because a country or an economy depends on functioning ecosystems and functioning climate upwind or in other parts of the continent. So what we find today, for example, through the Earth observations and modeling tools we have, is that many countries in the world not only get a significant portion of their precipitation from the ocean, but also from land. So you have regions in the world that are to more than 50% dependent on functioning ecosystem upwind because of evaporation of water from forests that then flow as atmospheric rivers downwind and provide your rainfall. So the Congo rainforest, for example, supplies rainfall to neighboring countries across the African continent. The Amazon rainforest does the same thing in South America, but so does the temperate forest in Europe. Flowing atmospheric rivers providing moisture to the east and shedding that as precipitation. This gives a very strong argument for water as a common good that has to be collectively managed, but also changes entirely our understanding on water, that it's, we have for decades recognized that transboundary river basins is an area where nations need to collaborate around upstream, downstream sharing of water, the Nile Basin being a classic example. So now we also have to recognize that we need to do exactly the same thing when it comes to securing how land generates green water flow, evaporation flows, that provides rainfall and precipitation. And that all of this is completely intertwined and the only way of securing stable fresh water supply in the future. So, neighboring countries have a diplomatic but also geopolitical reason to be good friends over shared water. So water is an economic common good, water behind all functions in the economy, and to address heads-on the climate-related water crisis are three key insights. And if you put that all together, what comes out of that is a whole new equity and justice agenda for water, that in order to have any chance of lifting people out of poverty, in order to have any chance of a safe climate landing that does not end up in climate impacts that are impossible to adapt to, we need to have investments in building water resilience. We need to put water right at the center of human and economic development. The first thing that decision makers just need to urgently recognize is that we can no longer count on a stable hydrological cycle or hydrograph. Things are changing very fast. Extreme events like droughts, floods, heat waves causing evaporation of water, deforestation causing complete changes in vapor flows, major land system changes, shifting green water, the soil moisture in soils. So all these changes needs to be put at the center for decision makers, so that you can take the right decisions on investments to build more resilient irrigation systems or dikes or storage systems. Or the most important challenge right now is to upgrade rain-fed agriculture in ways that it can cope with a higher degree of variability because of droughts and dry spells and floods. So decision makers must recognize that water is no longer stable. If you want to have jobs and prosperity in the future, you must have a stable water regime in your economy. If the world fails to safeguard the water cycle, we will fail with the Sustainable Development Goals. We will fail with eradicating hunger in the world. We will have more social instability, displacement, migration, and potentially conflicts. We know today that there is a worrying connection between climate change, ecosystem change, affecting water insecurity, which in turn spills over into food insecurity, which in turn spills over into social instability, which pushes communities away from their homes, which leads to displacement, but also to social instabilities. And this is why investments in water is also an investment in security, investment in stable societies. So that is, I would argue, the longer term number one challenge if we do not stop this trend of having more and more variable conditions.